In this video, you will see how Dynabeads coupled with protein A or protein G allow for immunoprecipitation in just three simple steps. By using the beads and a magnet, you can pull the proteins or protein complexes gently out of your sample, and this simplifies the separation, washing, and elution steps. First, you bind the antibody to the magnetic beads, then you incubate with your sample, and after a couple of washes, you elute your target protein. The manual that comes with the product describes the protocol in detail. This video offers a couple of additional tips and tricks. Before you start, you need to decide if the Dynabeads with protein A or protein G are best suited for your assay. This will depend on the type of antibody you are using. You'll find an overview of binding strengths of different antibodies in the product manual and on our webpages. No columns or centrifuge is required. The transparent top rack of the Dynamag 2 can also be used as a sample rack. Make sure the Dynabeads are fully resuspended. For a standard isolation, you'll need 50 microliters, but you can easily scale the protocol to match your experimental setup. One of the beauties of magnetic handling is that you can work with concentrated samples throughout the procedure, and you won't need to pre-treat or dilute the sample. You only need 1 to 10 micrograms of antibody. The exact amount will depend on your specific antibody, and you might want to titrate for minimal cost and maximum performance. During a short incubation, the antibody binds to the bead surface via their FC region. To avoid co-elution, along with your target protein later on, you can cross-link the antibody to the beads before you add the sample. You'll find a detailed protocol on the web. The beads are pulled to the side of the tube. Make sure you don't lose any liquid hiding in the cap. Now add your sample to the beads and pipette gently to resuspend. The rapid kinetics allows for a short incubation. This is especially important when you're working with protein complexes that might otherwise dissociate or be damaged by proteases during a longer incubation. All binding takes place on the outer surface of the Dynabeads, and in contrast to Sepharose, these polystyrene beads have no pores or inner surface to trap contaminants, and hence background binding is very low. In most cases, you won't even need to pre-clear your sample. The functionality of your antibody is critical for a successful result. If you know that your antibody has a low affinity, you might want to incubate for 20 minutes, or even up to 2 hours, as this can help increase the yield. Keep in mind that this might also lead to higher background binding. Good mixing is important, and we recommend using a sample mixer that allows for tilting and rotation, such as the Hula mixer. An alternative approach for low-affinity antibodies or difficult targets is to incubate antibody and sample before you add the beads. This could improve the binding kinetics and keep non-specific binding at a minimum. This indirect approach is also a good alternative when you're working with low-abundance proteins, as well as for protein and nucleic acid complexes, for example, in a chip assay. Just remember not to exceed the antibody binding capacity of the beads, as any excess free antibody will bind to the beads much faster than your protein complex will. Now you can remove all buffer without the risk of losing any of your sample. Magnetic separation allows for very easy washing. Here's a tip: when you resuspend the beads, you should not introduce air. You don't want to risk losing any protein bound to the few beads that might get trapped in that foam. We recommend to transfer the beads to a clean tube for the final washing step. This way you avoid any carryover of contaminants bound to the tube wall or the cap. Now you have a couple of choices. You can either resuspend your target protein while still attached to the solid phase and use this in your downstream experiments. You can elute the protein directly in your buffer for gel analysis or Western blotting. When you elute in a small volume, you can keep your protein concentrated. If you want to keep full protein integrity, you can elute under milder non-denaturing conditions. This is typically done by a 2-minute incubation at room temperature using low pH or high salt. Don't forget to bring your elute back to physiological pH after elution. The Dynabeads Protein A or Protein G are available both as a standalone reagent or as part of ready-to-use kits with buffers included. The beads are used for standard immunoprecipitation and to pull down larger complexes in co-immunoprecipitation. They are also well suited for chip and more recently for RNA immunoprecipitation.
Thank you.